Hey everyone, we see many tropes popping up in anime lately, and this might be old tropes resurface or new recent trend. I don't mean general ones like isekai or tsundere. I'm not saying these tropes are bad either, they definitely can be good if implemented well. Let's talk about support protagonists. We experience the story from their perspective, and they might have significant role as well, but they are not the main focus. They could take the strategist role, a sidekick, or a literal support character. The most prominent example is John Watson and Sherlock Holmes. For a majority of the cases, Watson is the narrator. We follow his account as he and Sherlock have their adventure solving cases. This translates to other medium as well. We see it in movie or the popular BBC series from the last decade. There are a few ways anime have done this. One notable example is the Fate series. Across many entries and spin-offs, the story mostly revolves around masters, who can summon historic figures to fight for them. They are the protagonists, but heroic spirits, like Saber in Stay Night or Ishtar on Grand Order, are better fit for adventure fantasy hero league. They are literally a legendary hero on their hero's journey. You can make the argument for Gilgamesh or Archer as well. Still, we experience the series through the master's point of view. It doesn't have to be a fantasy genre as well. Gekai Sensen is modern sci-fi, and the protagonist, Leonardo Watts, is actual support. Klaus, the leader, is definitely the hero. He's powerful, charismatic, and reliable. But through Leonardo, we see the corners of this fictional New York City and their inhabitants. Occasionally, he doesn't even have significant part on certain arc. In Black Lagoon, Rock is the narrator and protagonist. But Revy is the poster child and more famous character. She just has that badass anime look, while Rock is just a regular guy in extreme situation. It even takes it further in some episodes or the OVA movie, Roberta's Blood Trail, when even Revy becomes more of a supporting character to the titular Roberta and her group. Which leads me to the next alternative, the switch or passing of the mantle. Sometimes the usual protagonist would take a backseat, and another prominent character would take his place. Gohan and Goku did this switch in Cell Saga, where before this we followed Goku for years, and now Gohan was the lead. The author even specifically designed it this way. In Gurren Lagann, Kamina has the hero mantle. Then spoiler, he dies. And Simon takes over from the second arc. They actually did the passing of the mantle literally. You don't have to be all dramatic with deaths either. Other franchises have done this switch regularly. Lupin the Third has been around for more than 50 years. In many movies, Lupin let the other cast member takes the center stage. Well, he basically just sits around there. If not, there's usually a new character, like in the latest 3D movie, The First, which is straight up the story of Letitia, the granddaughter of famous archaeologists. And the cast just tag along in the adventure. So what's the point of using this kind of protagonist instead of the usual hero? Because the chosen one or legendary hero is so boring. Especially with the rise of isekai. Everyone is teleported to other world with smartphone or some shit superpower. It really becomes tedious. I think one of the reasons why ReZero is so famous, aside from the best girl, Rem, is because the MC, Subaru, is not your typical hero. In fact, the girls here, Amelia or Rem, would be more fit for a conventional hero in grand scheme of things. And this also gives fresh perspective. Things that normally wouldn't be crucial in normal story can be given more light. Keep in mind this is not exactly the same as narrative premise with duo or group setting. An ensemble cast is often to see rotating protagonists, as each member would have their spotlight and the story is the combination of all their narratives. The most basic is Power Ranger, I guess. Same thing with duo, where two different personalities inadvertently work together or clash with each other. The story would bounce back and forth between them. That means rival characters are also different thing entirely, like when Death Note focused on L at many points. However, this trope can be detrimental if not used properly. You don't want to follow the boring member of a party, especially when the series invests so much on them as protagonists. At once, the narrator becomes the burden or liability. Fairy Tail did this several times with Lucy. Not that it's not about her fight or dramatic scenes, because she had some spotlight here and there. The other examples I mentioned don't really fight that much either, but it's about her role in overall narrative. There are many arcs where she just damsel in distress, comic relief, or even fan service. This becomes repetitive. All things considered, I think this trope did more good than harm. I definitely would like to see more, if not for simply breaking the monotone of the Chosen One trope. My concern is this will be used as counter to the hero trope and eventually become overused. But so far, I like seeing the story from this support protagonist. And that's it for now. I have more other in-depth discussion with this trope or others. Let me know if it's something you're interested in. As always, thank you for watching. Please leave a like and comment. Consider subscribing and share with your friends. I make 3 videos every week. Have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next one.